by far the biggest in the land. Let's go. Consistency is key. Consistency is key. Don't stop the love. Uncle Dan is in the building. Wild Cherry Pepsi. Shout out FanMio, F-A-N-M-I-O, if you want to connect one-on-one with your favorite artists, athletes, etc. That's right. You know me, I'm ducking COVID. I'm ducking COVID. Terrellish is in the building. The fly guard. Don't stop the love. Oh yes. Wild Cherry Pepsi. Shout out to Trilla. Shout out to T-Lion. Everybody who participated in your wildest dream contest. Don't stop your love. Hovain, what's good? Hovain, what's good? What's really good? Brooklyn Babe, what's good? DJ Juanito, what's good? Joe Sabez, Countryman, OMG. There's no free lunch. Keep it, you're rich. Rich player, the garden here. Shout out to the executive producer, Azariah Malone Cartagena. Let me hear him when he goes, whoa. What they want from a, what they want from a, see, lover, when we get them silks in, what, Terrellish, they coming in tomorrow? Them silks are present tomorrow. Woo! All right, you can stop, you can stop. Yes, sir. Fly guy buddy on the check-in. Lindy Official, what's up? Shout out to 50 Cent. Shout out to Uncle Murder. Shout out to Blanco Cincha. Had a beautiful star, right? Who was with a star? Spin King. Had a beautiful dinner with those guys. First time out. I didn't know how to act. Al Boogie was good. It's so fancy. You love this shit, Fancy. You love this shit, Fancy. You love this shit, man. Fancy Nancy on the check-in. Toronto on the check-in. We are by far the big biggest in the game, and we unstoppable. And every day at 8 p.m., we give it to you. And we talk that shit. Today I came out. I had the mask on, but I actually touched the streets. And everybody I passed was like, yo, I watch your show every day. Yo, my father watch your show. Everybody, but we ain't playing with these dudes. Come from a real place. This that Papi Pudo right here. We the biggest in the game, Fancy. You know that shit. It's a 10 CEO. Yo, Callan. Callan, I might pull up on you tomorrow because I'm really, 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 Callan Aronson, it's a 10. We really need that stick. We really need that stick. You know what I'm talking about. I'm telling you, my sister, life or death, we need that. No Question. Shout out to Brazil, the Favelas. The Favelas is in the building. Yo, Eric B, what's good, bro? Last Detroit, what's up, my brother? Saving lives out there. Know what I'm saying? Yeah, sis. Blue. It's a 10 blue. The stick, I'm going to bring you one, but the stick got to be like blue. It's a 10 blue. Let me get the book. This is my sister, Bevelicious. When my daughter was born, she was at the hospital. She is family to the death. And Bevy Smith is coming on tonight to talk about her book. And we're gonna shoot the shit with all the other people. You know how that go. Fat Joe Fan, UK, one of the most loyal guys ever created. Thank you.
That's what it was.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, because you know how that go. Shout out to Toronto. Used to be the T dot, now it's the 666666.
It's DM.
I saw a documentary based on French Montana's life that I want to place bets. I want to place bets on if you're going to cry or get some tears. The man, I don't want to tell you everything about it, but the man, he's Muslim. It shows how he grew up with his family, Morocco, him going back to Africa, just so much. It was so amazingly done. I hadn't realized that I was in the documentary. And it was like really, 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 really. It was an honor for me to be a part of his life being told. And amazing. Like this shit is going to win something. This documentary going to win an award. I don't know if it's the film festival. I don't know where that shit going to be. Shout out to Tiffany Lighty. On the check-in, Chris Lighty's daughter. I'll call you after the show. Luis Miguel, te quiero, mi hermano, Colombia. Te quiero. Tiffany Lighty, Chris Lighty's daughter, says she loves seeing this. I posted a picture with 50. And of course, you know, Chris Lighty discovered 50. He discovered Fat Joe, and that's the reason why we brought peace, and we've been peace ever since. The man's kept his word, and I kept my word, and we break bread like family. We eat, it's all love, you know. And so, it is what it is. So French Montana's documentary, incredible, off the chain. Whenever it comes out, it is a must see. I love you too. And so we come on here every day. You know, we just had lobsters, shrimps, fish. They brought a fish out so big that it looked like they killed the Miami Dolphin, the logo. This shit was so big. D-Nice, you got D-Nice tonight, Pretty Lou? Pretty Lou got, right after this, Pretty Lou got the DJ show on Instagram. He is on fuego, on fire. They talked about the man on ESPN this week. They talked about the man all over TV. Cool Grims, what's up, my brother? Cool Mims, what's up? Red alert. Is my girl ready?
I'm going to have her ready for you right now.
T-Lover, let's get Bevy ready. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get to it. Lessons from a mother, auntie, and bestie.
What time do I tell Ted?
This woman is something else, Bevy. Huh?
Ted, what time do I tell
her? Stay close by. Last night was amazing day. We had your man Vegas Dave on here. We had a tribute. Yo, Rob Cash, what's up? We had a tribute to LL Cool J and Slick Rick, which was amazing. Jay Majors, what's up?
Rob Cash, good dude.
Rob Cash, a great dude. Shout out to Harlem on the check-in. And all our chili. And we come on here every day. We talk our shit. And I like to bring people in here who made it from nothing and filthy rich and just tell us all the obstacles they went to get where they at. And so we for the people completely. Technically, this is informative hip hop. Mrs. Khaled Khaled on the looking fly today. That's the second day you had a fly sweatsuit on that I gave you compliments on. Yeah, you blowing the bag, Nicole. Nicole, you
see the cherry pepper.
Nicole, you blowing the bag out here, man. Cause y'all, my sis, she don't care, but she been coming too fly. She's blowing the bag. She's blowing the bag. And so that's what I am, a vessel to talk to the people. And boy, we're going to have a great time tonight like we do every night. And so I'm over there eating steaks and lobsters. And I get up like 20 minutes ago and I said, listen, gentlemen, I got to go. Like, yo, crack, the food just started coming out. I said, listen, man, I got to get to my people. I got to do the big show. And they all start laughing because they know I'm on here. The whole COVID, been here. I've been by your side the whole time. And so I was talking to 50 Cent over dinner. Shout out E Philly. And I told him about recently, you know, someone had offended me, like a journalist or some shit like that. And the man said, Joe, this is one of the illest quotes. I wrote this shit down. He said, Joe, there's no sympathy for winners. There's no sympathy. Woo! And I was like, yo, you know what? Yo, baby, you looking beautiful tonight, man. What's going on, baby?
I love you, Joe, and thank you for having me on the biggest show ever.
Listen, we don't want to tell them your nickname with all my nephews. Big Titty Bab. Yo, Bab, stop. Yo, Bab, you gotta stop. Yo, Bab, I love you so much, sis. But I can, every time I see you, there's some key people that the minute I see you, I remember my daughter was born, and you were one of the first people there. And then my little nephews was there, and they were all going like this. And I was like, what the fuck they looking at? And then I look at Bev, because I'm pretty much, I'm spoiled. I've been used to them Bevelicious things. So I don't even pay attention, but they like, and I'm like, yo, what the fuck y'all look? So Bev, we bought 3 copies already.
Thank you, baby.
Nah, we on deck. Tell me why this book. Tell me about your journey. I know, but we got to let the people know.
Yeah. Well, the journey is this, Joe. You know, we are folks that come from New York, New York. So nice they had to name it twice. You know, you from the BX. I'm from Harlem. You know, so it's uptown for life. And where we come from, a lot of times they place limitations on what we can do, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was no exception. I come from a good family, like you come from a good family. Mm-hmm. But a lot of times when we're outside, we get so caught up with the streets that we kind of leave behind the best of who we are, Joe. Mm-hmm. And now I'm seeing you as a mature man, and the way you handle yourself and the way you handle your family, most importantly, lets me know that Joe has gotten back to the core of who he is. And I managed to get back to the core of who I am, which is Lulu Brown Bevy. But before I got back to Lulu Brown Bevy, you know, I was Big Bev from uptown, wreaking havoc in these motherfucking uptown streets. You know, I'm from the era of Paid in Full. I'm from the era of, you know, the tunnel, the red zone. I'm friends with Big Puff, Pac. I'm a hot girl in that era. And during that era, I had the most fun, but I definitely didn't show up as my most authentic self. And so now today, I've managed to put together Big Bev from Uptown, merge her with Lulu Brown Bevy, and sprinkle in Bevy Smith, Fashionista, and now that's who you're looking at today.
You know, Bev, it's a fact. It's I think we've grown to the point, I don't know if everybody did this before us and other generations, but I think I did enough fucking around. Right. And it's like, even now, I'm dropping a single next week. I'm sure Terrell tell you what it is, but I ain't telling nobody yet. For the big, big show, I got a soundtrack. Ain't that some shit?
I'm
hustling the soundtrack for the big, big show.
Yes.
And but it's grown, is fly grown shit. And I have no fear with doing some grown fly shit.
Exactly.
I'm not scared. And for so many years, I was scared. I was like, yo, you got to keep it young. You got to be like, mm-hmm. I'm not really scared about being my true self, like you said.
Yeah. But everyone needs to get to that point. And that's what the book is about. Because especially for those of us who come from humble beginnings, we all have to put on this tough exterior. Mm. Like, Joe, I'm sure who you were before the streets got to you was a really, really super sweet, sensitive guy. Because that's how you are with Azzy. And that's how you are with Lorena, which means that was always fucking in you. But the streets made you have to go like an animal.
It's in my book. I got a book coming out in a couple of months. And in my book, you see that point. And it's similar to like when you watch Paid in Full, because I'm thinking you, I think Harlem, when Rich was in the car and he was just crying. He said, anybody ever did something to me? Ever did something to, because his nephew I got kidnapped, but there was a moment in my life where I just blacked out. And before that, I had good grades. I was the nicest kid. I was a sweet kid. And the streets could do that. You know what I mean? And I asked God for forgiveness every night and try to explain, like, you know, it was my surroundings, God. Like, I was the way I was because I had no choice.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And so
you felt like you had no choice. You felt like, we feel like we have no choice. Like for me, I was bullied. So I was like, I don't want to be bullied. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I got to learn how to have some swagger. You know what I mean? Like, and you know, Joe, I used to play hooky from high school and go to the library.
You thought you was doing something.
Yeah, I was just like, but I wouldn't tell people I was going to the library. I'd be like, no, I'm not even going to that class. I'm out of here, whatever. And then I would go to the fucking library and read some fucking books. Okay? But I couldn't let no one know that. And I'll never forget the first time that Little Brown Bevy and Big Beth from Uptown met each other. It was when I started working at Vibe magazine. And I was a fashion advertising director. And Dame Dash was in the offices doing some kind of business. And when he came into the conference room I was in, he's like, what the fuck you doing here, Big Bev? And I was like, oh, I'm the fashion advertising director. He's like, how the fuck you get that job? I was like, oh, the entire time I was outside, I was going to school and I had a career. But I hid that. Like, Joe, literally, like, I hid the fact that I was a smart girl and that I was a driven girl and that I had all these dreams and aspirations. I hid it. Because even as a 20-something-year-old woman, even in your late 20s, the streets don't want to hear that shit.
Yeah, they don't want to hear that shit. You know, I was on a call today. I was on a Zoom with my girl, Erica Ford. You know her. She's a community activist. I met her through Tupac, right? Wow. And she'd been in the streets forever out of Queens and New York. And there's something coming up called Peace Week and trying to get the kids to put down the guns. And I think, and I'm not a genius or nothing, but I think with the street life, with business and entrepreneurs, we got to teach the youth earlier, right? So earlier. So like me, you know, I've been getting money forever, but I've been playing all type of games.
Right.
Now that I turned 50 years old, I got real serious about my money.
Right.
I'm real serious about my business. But I've been doing good the whole time, but now I'm like sharp.
Right.
But I think everyone should do that. 35 to 40 years old. 35 years old, you should be serious and sharp and everything. So that when you hit 45 years old, you got the bag and you can enjoy yourself.
Then you can enjoy yourself.
And the crazy thing about life, and I know kids that's watching, they heard this a million times, but the shit just be moving.
Yeah.
And so yesterday I took my mother and father to get the vaccine. They got in the list. They got the vaccine.
Yeah.
But I went and got them at 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. I got to hold my mother's hand, walking in the shit. And then the tables turned.
Yeah.
And now it's me holding my mother's hand and signing the paperwork,
yep,
making sure she get the vaccine. But what's crazy about that is that I look at them, they ain't but 20 years older than where I'm at now.
Right. Yeah.
And so the sense of urgency, the smell in the air, like I'm driving the car, smelling the air, I'm bumping my Keith Sweat, Don't Stop the Love.
Right.
And I'm just enjoying every moment of the day, everything that we can enjoy, you know. And because life really, really goes by really, 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 really quick. And when you turn around, you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah, and it comes at you fast. And in my book, Bevelations, Lessons from a Mother, Auntie Bestie, let's plug it. In my book, I actually talk about how, like, I changed my life at 38. Like, I was successful. I was the only Black person in management at Rolling Stone magazine. It was just a whole, you know, executive level of like just white folks. And the only Black people really at Rolling Stone were the writer Torre, who was on the edit side, but I was where the money resided. And then there was security guards and there was mailroom people. And I was making great money in 2005. I was making mid six figures and I quit to pursue a career in TV. And Joe, I fucking did it. And I did it as a grown-ass woman. And I did it with all of my Harlem swagger. And so the book is about how everybody should be never giving up on their dreams. I got a whole saying called, it gets greater later. And you are a living testament to that shit. Because Joe, one of the things I love most about you is that you're a fucking chameleon. And you keep going. And that's the reason why you're never really ever going to lose. You're always going to win because you know how to evolve. But everybody got to know how to pivot. And right now, because of the pandemic, people are having to pivot because they're being forced to pivot. And I'm going to tell you, if you out there listening to us, watching us, if you out of work or something like that, please go in and try to find a skill set and a passion of yours that you can turn into a business.
Mm-hmm.
When you go back, when you get another job, because I'm not telling everybody got to be an entrepreneur, but what I'm saying is everybody need multiple revenue streams. I make money from being on TV, on radio, as a public speaker. You know what I'm saying? And now it's
every little count. It's a pizza pie.
Yes.
You know, not too long ago, we so positive, baby. I won't go there, but it's a pizza pie. And at the end of the day, whatever goes in your bank account, goes in your bank account. Shout out to D Nice in the building. And another, we got to get...
Another one who pivoted and another one who comes from our community and continues to grow and evolve. Yeah. An American hero, D Nice.
Yeah, he's different. Yeah. You know, he's different than what he did for the people.
Yes.
Out of love, DJing during the COVID. And everybody coming together, feeling like we're somewhere because we're trapped in a house, we can't leave. And boy, what D Nice was able to do for the people. And you know, this COVID is this pandemic is like we haven't seen this in 100 years, man. Yeah.
Crazy.
You know, if you think all the people we know that died before this, they never get to see this shit.
Yeah.
With everybody wearing a mask, people got a vaccine, people got a this, everybody got to stay away. I mean, it's a real challenging time.
Mm-hmm.
And so I respect D Nice and the Verses
for
doing it. And then, you know, the Fat Joe Show. And then, you know, everybody who's doing their thing, trying to keep the people in good spirits.
Yeah.
Because it's a hard time.
It is a hard time. And people
And 1 second, Beth, it's normal for somebody to be going through some type of stress or mental issues. Because this ain't normal shit, Bev. And sometimes, no matter how tough you are, you can break momentarily.
Yeah.
So if you need help, you should get some sort of help because it's fucking real out here. It's really real.
It is. And that's a part of us going back to who we are at our core, though, right? Like, putting down the tough guy or the tough girl persona and being like, you know what? I need some help. You know what I mean? Like, I need to go talk to I need a shoulder I can lean on. I need to go cry somewhere. You know what I mean? Like, there's so much strength in being vulnerable. You know, and I think oftentimes when you come from communities like ours, you always think of the biggest, toughest person as the strongest one. But it's really those people that know how to humble themselves and admit mm-hmm. when they hurt and admit when they need some help. Those are the strongest people. And so, you know, for me, in my book, I'm trying to give folks some help, but I'm also admitting when I've been vulnerable. I admit when, you know, I went all the way left and really left my truest self. You know what I mean? And
what do you mean by that, Bev, when you say you left your truest self? Like, let's be honest about this. Let this open up. Yeah. What are some of the things you did that you really wouldn't have did if you was truly yourself?
Oh, wow. Well, a bunch of shit. But, like, you know, like, Joe, for real, like, I was so miserable, like, in my, like, late 20s, early, like, my early 30s. Mm-hmm. Like, in the Salon Song, I tried to sleep it away, shop it away, fuck it away. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I remember, like, when I stopped going on dates and drinking heavily, that cut down on a lot of my body count.
Oh, yeah, because, you know, the liquor part of the trick.
Yes, yes.
You know what I mean? Even a guy like me that don't like to drink like that, you know you got to get the liquor involved to score the home run.
Right, exactly.
So you might have to take a drink or two and fuck yourself up in the meantime.
Right, exactly. So my body count went way down, you know what I'm saying? And you know, and while I don't have any regrets about that, in the book I refer to it Fucks and Fumbles. You know, I'm so glad.
When fucks and fumbles?
Yeah, fucks and fumbles.
What you mean by that? That's dope.
Right? It's just like, you know, a lot of them fucks was fumbles. Like, they shouldn't have never happened. You know what I mean? Like, you look at the people and you're like, really, though? That's who you chose? Like, you know what I mean? But again, because I was miserable, I was trying to find different ways to make myself happy. I was also a shopaholic. You know, I worked in fast.
And that's a crime in itself. Yes. Like, I've been a shopaholic. I still am a shopaholic, but the COVID made me slow down and be focused because we can't go nowhere. So why am I going to be buying all this fly shit every day if I can't even go nowhere, right? Yeah. So that helped me. But I do have a problem with being a shopaholic, and people don't understand what that is. It means if you like to be fly, you like fly shit, you want to buy it. And everybody, I would say Floyd Mayweather's a shopaholic.
Oh, he's a shopaholic.
He's like a fucking predicate felon of shopping. He got to buy some shit all the time.
Yes, yes. And listen, I'm not going to knock nobody's thing. But what I am going to say, for me, it was like self-medicating. Because I literally, and Terrell would be with me, because so I worked in fashion. So I had discounts at every store. You know, so I would hit Fifth Avenue, Fendi, Dior, Gucci. I bought free shit out of Vuitton, which is very hard to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it was
You can't get free shit out of none of that shit.
Yeah.
Or a discount.
Yeah, exactly. I got discounts everywhere. But it was sexy, right? Because you go into the store, they know you're a VIP customer, and you're not even a VIP customer because you spend money. You're a VIP customer because you're a fashion executive. So they treat you differently. You get the private dressing room. You get the champagne as soon as you come in the door. It was sexy, right? So if you're a miserable person, when you get that, when you're going in there and then they taking things out, this really, truly limited edition, it's sexy. And you start feeling that high. You get that high. You get that high. And then guess what happened? When you buy the shit and you get home and after you take the bag and you like, and it's nothing. It's really nothing.
That happened to me all my life. Like, if I wanted a car, and I finally got the car, and then you get bored of the car, and then you try to do shit to just make you want to go get something. You know, that's the story. Like, yo, Terrell, have you ever been satisfied with Terrell? You ever been satisfied with buying fashion? Because you go shopping every day. Have you ever been like, oh, I'm good now? No. You can't fill that cup. She's the flyest guy we know.
The fly.
Like, I mean, nobody can fuck with Terrell. Like that. That's a, you know, Terrell. You know what I told Terrell? We shooting a video on Monday, COVID free. Everybody taking the test, taking the thing, and so Terrell. I tell him, yo, Terrell, I need that shit. So, you know, we've been doing this for so many years. He said, but what you talking about? I said, well, I need the outfit that Terrell would wear if he was showing up to another stylist's birthday party. And you know how Terrell be coming in there humble with the fly shit on, like he really don't know he got the fly shit on. I'm like, yo, that's what I want. I want that shit right there.
And he's going to get it for you.
Oh, no, he's going to get it. He won't get it. I mean, Terrell is the man. Bab, let me ask you something, because when I talk to you or anytime, it screams Harlem. Give me like five of the dopest moments you experienced in Harlem.
Wow, there's so many dope moments. The rooftop.
We'll take the rooftop as one. Rooftop. And for those who don't know, the rooftop, that wasn't paid in full. That was at Harlem. That was the fly spot. All the hustlers, all the rappers. That was the first time I ever seen Heavy D. I was at the rooftop, and Heavy D was out there. He was my idol. You know, he's still my idol. Rest in peace. But I actually seen Heavy. And I was like, oh, shit, Heavy out here. Mm-hmm. You know, LL. Yeah. Everybody used to come uptown to the rooftop.
And there was a roller skating rink.
It was.
And it made people just crazy. And I lived five blocks from the rooftop.
Mm.
In my backyard, Joe. So that was like one of my highlights. Then, of course, your home away from home, Rucker. Again, five blocks away from where I grew up.
So you used to play the Rucker in the glory day of the Rucker. You was out there.
Oh, my God, yes. As a matter of fact, one of my guys was a kingpin, and he used to stop the game when I came on the court because he would, like, stop the game down so I could walk across the court and take my seat. And this is before Rucker went corporate.
So he would stop the whole game like Bevy here.
Yeah, because I would come through in my like Versace or whatever, because you know I worked in fashion, so I would have all my outfits and everything. You know, I had all that Audi, and I would just come through, and they'd be like, you know, they would call me his name, Miss Blah Blah Blah. You know what I mean? And it was a good life. It was
a little movie going on there.
It was a little movie.
So you got the rooftop and the Rucker, that's across the street from each other. You right there.
Right there.
That's Heavy Polo Grounds.
Yep, exactly.
55th.
Yeah.
What would be another moment?
We got to talk about the Willie Burger stand.
Oh, yeah. Willie Burgers, that was it. For me, coming from the Bronx, I come over 149th, go over the bridge, come down in my car, blasting my system in the truck, go up to the top of Sugar Hill, come back, make the U-turn. And me, I've always been like adventurous or daring. You know, I love getting out the car, fat Puerto Rican nigga with 10 chains on, no shirt on in the summer, keep doors open and just order me some Willie Burgers and just daring. Just, I wanted people to look at me like, yo, this guy crazy over here. Like, he's nuts. And Willie Burger and the burgers.
It was a full
on. We always mention Willie Burger like a landmark, but the actual burgers was incredible.
Incredible. Well, but then Jimbo's took over.
Yeah, Jimbo all over.
Yeah, Jimbo took
Jimbo
over.
Jimbo like the burger mafia in the hood. Right.
Exactly. So it was Willie Burger, and then of course the Apollo on Wednesdays.
Ooh.
Traffic stopped. From river to river, it was bonkers. It was the best of times. It was the
listen, Bab. I was there, and I was there as a hustler, getting money, going there every week. I used to throw money at people performing.
That's right
on stage, and it was always no disrespect. I don't know where they got them from, but it was always a fat chick that would come on after we would have fun and we go, and I am telling you, and we'd be like, ah! We went for the same trick every week in the Apollo. I'm not going. And she kick her shoes off and everybody throwing it every week.
Every week.
We fell for the same same thing, yo. That was like, oh my God, that was it. We come outside, Big Daddy Kane be out there with the wide body kit, Benz, the cherry red shit, iced out. Mike Tyson be in the hallway.
Mike Tyson.
I am Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson during that era spent so, he endowed so many people in the community. It was crazy. When people don't understand, that was such a golden era. He wasted so much money. It's no wonder he went broke. But thank God he made it back now.
He's doing great. Boy. Yeah, but Mike Tyson was out there spending that money. He was in there fighting Mitch Green.
Yes.
He was over there with Dapper Dan. He was he lived in Daps.
Yeah.
And I remember the first time I seen Mike Tyson, he was in the first floor lobby of the Apollo. First time ever. Mm-hmm. All I saw was the back of his neck.
Okay.
And his neck was so big that I was like, oh, shit, I am Mike. And I remember walking by him, I got a little rope chain on with the anchor, and I'm trying to make him see me like, you know.
Hey.
You got four there. What's the next one?
Oh, the next one. I got someone mentioned it in the comments. I would say Grant's Tomb.
Oof.
Tomb was the best.
Oh, God, Grant's Tomb.
I call him in the summertime any old way.
And you know, I think of Grant Zoom, I think of great, 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 great times. But I also think of where Rest in Peace Wolf.
Oh, yeah.
And Anthony, their funeral was over there in Grant Zoom.
Yeah.
Remember, Puff rented the whole Grant's Tomb, and it was the best service I ever been to.
Yeah.
You know, over there in Grant's Tomb. But Grant's Tomb, and it's crazy, right? Because when you drive through these areas now, and we got the memories. It's almost like it never happened, right? And it's
almost like it never happened.
It's like, yo, these kids didn't know it was popping in Grant's Tomb.
My friend Mark just said, what about Bentley's? Bentley's was the place that you went when you wanted to get your grown and sexy on. That's when your hustler guy had to put on his slacks.
Wow. And the one of the greatest moments, and I ain't get to go there, but I seen Terrell in pictures. I think it was Fashion Week, and they took out all the seats in the Apollo, mm-hmm. and then they made like a tent in the schoolyard in the back.
Yeah.
What event was that, Bevy? You was there, right?
Actually, the Apollo Gala. They do a gala every year, and they do that, and it's bonkers.
So explain it to the people, because...
We've seen everyone from the Ozzy Brothers perform there. We've seen... You know, Prince performed there at the gala. Like, it just all the biggest stars have come through the Apollo Gala. And what they do is they sell tickets. It'll be like $10,000 for, a ticket because it's for a gala. It's a fundraiser. And then afterwards, it's a beautiful after party. It's no VIP. So you, like, standing right next to
somebody. Right next to somebody. You're right next to Babyface.
Yeah, right. You know, it's not like no VIP shit. Because if you're in there, first of all, it's $10,000 a ticket. So it's probably not going to be any riffraff up in there. So
there ain't no bums in there.
Yeah.
And I was so jealous one year. I seen Terrell in there. And I was just like, what the fuck? Because, you know, I started in the Apollo, amateur night at the Apollo.
Right, I know.
I came 4 weeks in a row, first place. So I know the Apollo well.
Yes.
And it's my home.
Yeah.
And so when he showed me that, I was like, get the fuck out of here. They did that shit in Apollo? Like, he was like, yo, it was flying. Russell Simmons was over here. And this one was, I was like, yo, T Love, are you serious?
Yeah, that's a good thing. When the world opened back up, we'll go.
Oh, I gotta go. Like, now it's no question. And so the book, can we tell the people how to get their hands on this book?
Okay, you can go and find Bevelations, Lessons from a Mother, Auntie, Bestie, anywhere where books are sold. Or you can go to my website, bevysmith.com. And we have, you know, but it's everywhere. It's Amazon, it's Barnes & Noble, it's your local bookstore, it's everything.
You know, Bev, I remember your birthday when you was in Vegas. So I had a show in Vegas.
Yes, oh, we had
And they turned around and they said, Bev's in town, it's her birthday. And you and Amy, shout out to Amy Morris. She used to work with me. and all your friends was out there. And I said, tell Bev I got her. So you come, you got all the champagne. Like you're supposed to. You know, we live a life, Bev. Yeah. We never short of nothing. We always live life like it's the last day.
Exactly.
We don't ball, right?
Exactly.
So we over there, and I remember I'm talking to you, and you got the TV show, and my man, who's my friend, who's in Hollywood, he's hitting me up like, Joe, get me in. And I'm like, no problem. He's a good friend of mine. And when he comes, you stand up, and you're like, yo, Joe, this is my boss.
Yeah.
This is the guy. You remember that shit, man? And I was like, Chris, that's my guy. And you was like, yo, Joe, this is my boss.
Yeah.
And it was so crazy that he was hitting me to get in, but you was there with us. And it's just it's the way the world's so small.
Yes. But it's also, too, a testament to our resilience and the way we keep moving, Joe, because we're always in rooms that they don't expect us to be in. You know, we've traveled the world. You know, you've done Milan Fashion Week. You know, I've done Milan Fashion Week, Paris Fashion Week, London Fashion Week. And we're from where we're from. And that's just a testament to how we're built. And I want people to understand that, like, there's no limit to this. And you don't have to front about it. You can look up, yep, Harlem Candle Company.
I just said, you know, you need to put your Harlem Candle.
My girl.
Hey, yeah, you see Nicole, you, Mrs. New Rose Harlem, look at Nicole. Yeah, yo, bad, man. You got too much love, bad.
That's my whole
I love
Harlem
it.
Candle.
Yes.
What is this candle about?
That's a Harlem Candle Company. That's made in Harlem. It's by a black girl who makes candles, and that's called the Langston after the great Langston Hughes.
Langston Hughes?
Yeah.
Woo!
It's really good.
Man. Yeah. I was going to tell you, T Lover, you want to say hi to...
She
you're not doing that?
No, she knows I love it.
How's your mother doing?
My mom is doing great. She's doing great.
No, it's her mother's birthday.
Yeah, she just had a birthday.
93?
93.
You know, I see your mom. She just be like,
yeah.
And she's, and thank God. She's so focused.
Yeah.
Full of life. She's sharp.
Yeah, she's sharp. She loved meeting you, too. Loved meeting you. I was
man,
like...
The last thing I will ask you, right, because you're so strong in the LGBT community.
Yes.
They love you.
Yeah. I love them.
You love them. What was the embracement? I know we all family, we all, but you got a special bond.
Yes.
Like you know, they love you. Like you're the,
yes.
You're the mothership.
Yes.
What is it? What is it with you and the LGBT community? What makes that so special, that bond?
Well, here you go. So here's the thing. Did you know that the original gay balls that you see on Pose and on Legendary and all that, all these TV shows that you're seeing now, and Madonna's Vogue and all of that all came out of Harlem. The original gay balls came out of Harlem. So Harlem was always very, very gay friendly. So when I grew up, I literally didn't even know it was some people that felt that being gay was a problem or was a stigma. Because in my community, gay people just, as long as you can hold your own, oftentimes, you know, like, oh, remember on Fame, Tony Ray?
Leroy?
Did you know this, Joe? Did you know that his mother was a drug queenpin? Her name was Jean, too. And she was a drug queenpin. As a matter of fact, she was one of the, she worked with Guy Fisher. And I had Guy Fisher on my radio show because Debbie Allen is working with him to get his life produced as a TV show and as a film. But we were talking about that.
So he did your show. He didn't do mine. I was on him the first day.
For real?
He out here in Florida. I was like, yo, God, try to hook me up with God.
Yeah.
And I told him, too. We got on the phone. I was like, yo, don't let these suckers interview. You know, you got to come to the real. Like, yeah. You know what I mean?
But you know what, though? I will tell you this, Joe. Guy Fisher is, you know, a legendary for what he did in the street, but he wants to talk about what he's doing.
Education, what he did in jail. He became like a doctor. Like what he got? What he do in jail?
He's Dr. Fisher. So he went and he got his GED, and then he got multiple degrees while he was in jail. And then he started all these great programs to teach inmates how to write screenplays and books and things like that. So when he came on my show, you know, I'm from Harlem. He's from Harlem. And he really did not want, because I know a lot of people that know God Fisher. You know what I'm saying? So, because even though I'm much
younger. You know a lot of people that know God Fisher?
Yes. So
yeah, me too. He was from Patterson Projects in the Bronx. Right. But let me tell you some crazy shit, though, Beth. Because, look, Harlem has always been the mothership of Black people.
Yes.
Especially creative, fashionable Black people. I'm talking about since day one. If you go Madam C.J. Walker, you go all those times, it was Harlem. Everybody was trying to get to Harlem.
Yes.
Right? And so Guy Fisher owned the Apollo.
Yeah.
He was the one of the biggest kingpins. So when he came out of jail, all my Harlem people was posting him trying to claim him as Harlem. And then I had to step up and stop it and be like, yo, that's BX Patterson Projects. Y'all need to stop.
Right. But he did, but he made all of that lucrative money and he made his bones in Harlem. So that's what you
know. That's it. I mean, that's a me too. Coming up, that's where I was at. Right. And but what's so special about Harlem before we go? That we got guys that grew up in other boroughs claiming Harlem and they're not really from there.
Yeah.
Like I've seen it.
Yes, we've seen it.
I'm talking about big artists saying they from Harlem. And I know they from the Bronx because I know they sisters.
Right.
They big sisters and all that. So I be like, oh, word, Harlem?
Mm-hmm.
Not Crotona Park?
Right.
Not East Tremont?
They do it.
So it gives you, so Bev, when you go to a party, let's say a Rock Nation brunch in LA or something like that, you walking in like Bevy from Harlem.
Yes, definitely. Because you got to remember too, like, I knew Jay-Z when he was a hustler. You know, like, so all of us, we kept up together. You know what I mean? He knew me when I was just a girl at the bar, you know, trying to get my champagne, you know what I'm saying? Trying to get my bottles and everything. And I knew him when he was a hustler. And then, you know, we all came up together. So why would I ever try going there as Bevy Smith, the lady, or, you know, Bevy Smith, the author? Like, no, I'm just going in there as myself. And, you know, but I do love it. Like, oh, perfect. I went to Tyler Perry's studio opening. You know, he did that phenomenal studio, and I went. When I tell you, when me and Terrell saw Puffy, it was almost tears for us because that's hard right there. Like, we were like, oh, my God, look at this shit. It's the same thing when the Barack Obama inaugurations. Partying in the White House with D-Nice spinning, that type of shit. And you think about the fact that we're from the hood, the real hood, like not like a suburb or not something that's like.
Nah. We from the soil. And he said, and you do something that I've done my whole life. And you never go home the same way.
Right.
So if you come out and make a right, you're making your way to come out and make a left or go through the basement. My brother, shout out my brother, the Money Man. He taught me that since I was a kid in my projects. Yeah. He said, never go out the same way. So I would go to school, front door. I would go to school the next day through the basement. I would come out my house, go to the right. I would do a little extra so that nobody could really, really clock me. And I know you do that, Bev.
Yes. How did you know that?
Because I know things, Bev. Don't do that to yourself.
Same way. I'll
tell you the truth. I've done it several times with Terrell in the car with me. And one time he told me, yo, you know Bev does the same thing. She won't go back the same way. She, even if it's easy, it's like, yo, we got to switch it up on them. Shout out to Lisa from Cold Jam. She's in here.
And it's her birthday. Happy birthday, Lisa.
Yo, Lisa, I didn't know it was your birthday.
She's so beautiful.
I didn't know it was. It's her birthday.
A birthday, even if it's today or tomorrow or yesterday. But yeah.
Oh, God bless Lisa. I remember when I had her on here, you was in the comments saying, don't lie, you had a crush on her, Joey.
Right. That means she's bad, she's still bad, you know what I mean? It don't change. But you know what, Joe? I want to just give you your flowers right now, too. You are such a beautiful individual. You always have been. You're gracious. And I'm going to tell you, there's only been two men in hip-hop that have... Because So everybody should know, when I work in fashion at Vibe, I'm working with celebrities. And a lot of times, even when you're a woman, if you're working with celebrities, they're still in their mindset, they're celebrities and they're the most important thing. Only two men in hip hop have ever taken beautiful care of me, and that's T.I. and Fat Joe.
Wow.
Joe, I've never been in your presence, and you've not been like, come on, Bev, we got, And like, you just back everything up. You make everybody good. You know how to take care of the women that are in your company. You are a proper gentleman. T.I. the same way. When I took T.I. to Milan, it was his first time ever overseas. And I took him to Milan for the fashion shows. And all the photographers were taking his pictures. And you know, Milan got all them cobblestones. And I had on like a 6-inch heel.
Yeah.
Of course, the cobblestone not bust my head wide open. T.I. realizes I'm not by his side. He turns around. He sees me struggling on the top cobblestones. He says to the photographers, hold up. He goes back, takes my hand, and gets me across the street. And then he goes back to doing the paparazzi shit. But and then he's done that countless amounts of times in clubs, you know, just making sure, like, whatever I wanted, you know what I mean? But there's not a lot of men like that in this business, because a lot of times the men are so used to being coddled and being celebrities that they act like a bigger woman than any woman with a vagina. But
you know, I gotta
amazing.
Yeah, you gotta stop. Yo, Bev, I got a friend out here, another woman, female. I can tell you one thing. They welcomed me to Clubhouse, right? And I didn't know how it worked. But when I went to Clubhouse, welcome Fat Joe or celebrate Fat Joe or something, I didn't know how it worked, right? But now that I know how it works, and I'm not the most perfect guy in the world, but I'm really, really impressed, because the people who hold the floor in Clubhouse, you are on the stage, mm-hmm. there's certain people. All the people that held that stage were women.
Yes.
For me.
Yes.
They were like my security. Yep. So you had Tina Davis, you had Robin from Baller Alert, you had Natina. They formed Voltron around me.
Yes.
Like, all right, Joey, you could talk to Joey. Right. All right, you could talk to Joey. And when I went back in there and started realizing Clubhouse, I said, man, I have a lot of women that feel really comfortable, like with Jody. Because now that I know what's up with Clubhouse, they held me down. They was like, ain't no bullshit getting through here.
Yes.
Like, they throwing Voltron on me.
Yes.
And I take pride in that. I'm not perfect, but I love that all the women I know could feel comfortable around me, could feel free to not think that, you know, one of the number one questions that guys ask me behind the scenes is, have you ever looked at J-Lo's ass? And I tell them, I never looked at her ass.
Right.
Why? Because we have a sister-brother relationship.
Right.
I never want her to look back and see me looking at her ass.
Right.
That's nasty.
Right, exactly.
Right, if it wasn't brother and sister, it'd be like, hell yeah, I gotta look at J-Lo ass.
But you're not brothers, and you're not a predator, and you're not thirsty. It's like, come on. Lorena got one of the best asses in the game. You good.
Boy, do I love it.
I know.
Boy.
We all love it.
You know, I was in Wendy Williams like 2 weeks ago. I love Wendy. And Wendy was like, yo, your wife's so beautiful. What is it? I was like, it's the ass for me. That's that ass for me. Yo, Bev, I love you. Thank you for coming on.
Baby.
Revelations. We already bought 5-10 copies. Everybody needs to get this book. My sister, she does her thing. Harlem Candle.
Yes.
Langston News.
That's right.
And yo, Bev, you know what I like, Bev, is that I love that you don't have to ask nobody to promote your shit.
No.
And so I wake up the other morning, and the first thing I'm talking about, I just woke up, grabbed the phone, Terrell posts the book.
Yes.
Before that book gets to go like this, boom, I post it.
Yeah.
And before my shit get to go like this, my wife, boom, and just everybody that knows us is like, boom, 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 talent. Everybody, boom, 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 boom. Because you got that kind of love.
I do.
We want to see you do great.
Thank you, baby. I love you. And thank you for...
I love you, baby.
And give your producer my love. You know I love Azzy. You know,
Azzy's over there. You know, she's up top.
Okay.
Love you, babe.
I love you, too. Bye, baby.
All right. Bye-bye. Woo! You don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. We know everybody. Bev's my sister. Support that book, Revelations. Support this book and everything my sister does. And so this is what this is about, man. And we're not going to let the media, we're not going to let these blogs and all that talk about our people the wrong way. That's what this is all about. The power of media is to control the narrative and show young sisters that they could become successful like Bevy. That's what this shit is all about. Showing you that it's possible. That's what the big show is all about. And I never have a boss. I'm always the boss. So we say what we want to say. Shout out Pepsi Wild Cherry, great sponsor. So we got to control the narrative and keep bringing people up here that came from nothing like us and became successful. That's what I do every night to you guys. Every night.
Hold up.
We're not up here jamming our icons or catching clickbait or bringing people up here that don't tell the truth. We up here talking the truth. I see my man Calm Body in the things. I didn't know him personally. I saw his story of triumph and I hit him up and said, yo, I need you on the show, bro. We need to inspire brothers that just come home from jail. That's what this show's about. Test Move, my brother. Harlem, take it away. I gotta use the restroom. I'll be back in 1 second, but I need you to take it away.
I'll play some elevator.
I want the music up. The music up, Ted. Make sure it's loud.
The music is always up, Joe. Hold
on. No, you sound low.
One time in Florida. Come on, stop. Yo. We're gonna let Joe go do what he do. In the meantime, in between time. It's a Harlem type of vibe tonight, huh? What we doing? What y'all want to do? But they shot the Lisa and all that good vibe. Huh? Okay, that was nice. Hold on. Let's get into some, this is a Harlem type of night. It's a Harlem type of night. Hold on. It's a Harlem type of night. What we doing? What we feeling like? Hold on. Hold on. We gonna let Fat Joe get back in the vibe. Shout out to Bruce B. He mentioned that rooftop. We gotta get in the vibe. Hold on. We talking the rink on Wednesday. We talking that drop 325. What's up? What's up? It's a Harlem type of vibe.
You remember?
Woo!
For your record to the wax.
Holy shit. Hey, what are we doing? Shout out to the world famous Brucey B. We can't talk no rooftop without getting into that Brucey vibe, yo. You got me hyped over here.
That I ever spit.
Alright, let's get to that rooftop anthem. Let's get to that rooftop anthem. Hold on. No! You know what it was. recipe star tell. You can pre the whole thing, you know what it is. Let it ride out. Somebody get Bruce and be on the line right now. Lord have mercy. Yo, get out the way. Wild Cherry Pepsi. Get out the way. Wild Cherry Pepsi. On a Friday. Oh, shit. Oh, no. This ain't that Mary J. Blige. All respect to. Woo.
The remix came.
No, baby. Run the numbers up. Let's go. Come on. Not Harlem Talk Show. Shout to Master Z, you know, here we go. Hey. Oh. 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 Hollywood!
Rappers,
hey, yo, hold on!
It's Hollywood now, back from the day.
Come on!
Give me something.
You went to that pop before I go to bed. You went to that rooftop. Went to that Apollo.
The climb on the highest mountain and do it all.
You won't get into it.
Before I go to bed, you remember all the bitches that's in the scene. I'd rather not be away. So every time this thing comes up, everybody would have to say,
hold on, rooftop.
One, two,
three. You know. There ain't no way that I can let you know me. Hey, yo, come on, Joe. Hey, yo. Daddy B, come on.
The MC, and I'm here to explain why I do it. Woo. You can't stop this flame anytime that you want it.
Only on a Friday.
Never. And you can bet money that I'll deliver. The satisfaction is guaranteed. You want a break from weaklings? You need. Oh. The style that I'm explaining, you want it to pay it. Listen to every word that I'm saying. Keep using me until I'm all gone. Like a sponge soaking up this song. I won't complain, just say my name. To keep me motivated, never refrain from rocking your bottom. Yes, I got them. Lyrics so deaf, I think I should bottle them. This is different, that you know, and I think you better use me.
Harlem! Oh, we all Harlem Bronx today, hold on.
You remember?
Hey, look, hey, my.
What's up?
This line.
What?
Alright, we gon' get it on.
Nah.
Smoke.
What are we doing?
I drink.
Me too.
Oh, good. We gon' get it on.
Got drops,
got trucks, got
jeans.
Alright, we gon' take it right.
I'm moving around.
So my,
what's up?
Let's slide.
Alright,
hold on.
And we gon' get
it right. Now it's
shape. You remember?
Shape.
What we doing?
Who wanna mess with me, or can mess with me?
What?
Be a mess to clean, call me Mr. Clean. Where I glitz and gleam, trigger team, click the beam, hit the beam, get a lean, clicking like I'm nicotine.
What?
But it's all for the green like Listerine.
What?
After this the queen, thinking I'ma get a
hey, hold on.
I ain't genuine, mom, my mission's mean. Or my nigga Dean, fix the fix, get the cream.
Hey, yo, Fat Joe, Sunday night, leg quarter, around 2:35, maybe like 3 o'clock. Around that time, when
day.
I rep this thing, go!
Hey, yo, you love the way I rep black,
what?
Step at that. But we haven't done a chest chat, respect that.
What?
Any girl I met that, hit that. Love the way I spit that, and I'm kick that.
Killer!
Break that, get your shit snap, get your ribs cracked. Got a front, have it kick that, get that, sit back. Spooch,
we all
that. Learn how to flip back for the big stacks and the big act. Now I got the big that, big black.
Oh. No! Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Who else going
down?
Huh?
I gotta calm down.
Look at that.
Hey, no.
beautiful mansion.
What we doing?
Cameron Jobs.
What we doing?
And I'm Mason Becker. And it's entertainment. And we're gonna rise to the top.
Lisa, birthday, Joe.
The Chancellor.
Lisa, birthday, Joe. Pop-up. What we doing?
Yo, you might see Cam in designer underwear, now reclining leather chair. The mind is everywhere. Now we pull up in the whip, the mind is stopping stare. And when it comes to girls, they behind us everywhere. I mean, when I hang up on them, they pressure it down. I mean, what the hell is it? Why you stressing me, child? It'd be one thing if you were finessing my style. But when I go to court, you know the dress of the trial. You're not my wife, so in fact for sex I'll be fouled. Be down, only question, better be half. Threaten me now, bet me down, no girl threaten me now. And the SD was gone, are you sexy and thongs? If your sex in this Lexus,
hey, yo, Joe.
Shout out J1's, J1's.
Let me apologize to myself.
Correct,
CTR. How are we gonna talk any Harlem when I got one of the, I think one of the most legendary records in Harlem of all time?
Lord.
Uno,
two.
Lord.
Uno,
two.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
What?
Uno, uno, uno.
Hey, Fat Joe.
Mic check.
You know where I got Ten Smooth, Straight Face, you remember? You know where I got that from?
Yeah.
Do you know?
Brand new.
Do you know?
Collaboration. Ten Smooth, Straight Face, you remember?
No.
Along with.
That's a Joker moment.
It's a Harlem. Knock, knock.
Oh.
Who is it? Voice of Harlem. I'm too busy. And I can't stay long. Long enough to lay your song. Chicken noodle, chicken noodle, chicken noodle soup.
That was a joke from me.
Chicken noodle, chicken noodle soup.
Ow!
Chicken noodle, chicken noodle, chicken noodle soup. Hey, chicken noodle, chicken noodle.
Let it ride.
You remember? You know I'll do it. I don't even need no music. Uno, dos, tres.
Everybody!
No music! No music. No music. No music. No music. Come on, come on.
Hey yo, up, hey yo, man? Yo Joe, yo Joe.
What's up?
Yo Joe, and then your man Nori stepped in.
I do the bend and stretch, keep it going. I do the bend and stretch one more time.
Nori, Puff Daddy,
going do the bend. Just keep it going, do the bend. Stretch, keep it going, do the bend. And stretch one more time, do the bend. And stretch, keep it going, do the bend. And stretch, keep it going, do the bend. And stretch, keep it going, do the bend. And stretch one more time, do the bend. And stretch, keep it going, do the bend. And stretch, keep it going, do the bend.
I ain't seen you smile in a while. Yo, I ain't seen you smile in a while, Joe. I ain't seen you smile in a while.
Get y'all in touch.
DJ Hot Day Queen, you know.
This kind of love.
Gordo, what up?
Once in a lifetime.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
You wanna take the chance.
You remember?
I see it on your face. You know my love's the answer.
Come on.
Girl, don't be afraid.
We in Harlem.
I know just what to do. Gonna be the shining star.
Ooh.
I know just how to rescue you. I've been waiting for
the sun goes down.
And in between, we gotta find the dream. That next life will come.
Shout out the mayor, shout out the mayor.
You're searching here, you're searching there.
The work is done, you found the love and someone you care.
Might as well barbecue and boogaloo.
All the ladies on the check, and what y'all looking like? What y'all feeling like? Hold on. Woo! Feel good on a Friday.
I'm taking out this time to give you peace of my mind.
about to go to London, but stay in Harlem. That's how we do this,
I don't want no romance, I just want the chance to show you that I'm for real.
That's how I do it.
And I let myself go.
Woo.
I said so many things, things he didn't know. And I was so bad. I don't think he's coming back.
He... Get that motherfucking soul clap going on. Somebody clap their hands. Hurry up. Immediately. Clap, clap, clap it goes in. And just keep it over the head.
One request.
Always so good.
Coming down. This ain't a Harlem song, but it is. But when I used to drive to Willy Burger and I would have the Jeep with the top off, I would always play, I wanna sex you up.
Oh, man. Okay, you
and
know what?
So from New Jack City, when the girl that used to be G Money's was with Nino and she was dancing up on that thing to, I wanna sex you up. Sheesh.
So check this out, Joe. So check this out. Hold on. I'm gonna say one thing. Every time this record comes up, there's two versions to this record. We don't do the second version, Joe. We don't do come inside take. We don't do that. We do original. TikTok, yeah. We only do original.
TikTok, you remember?
No, we only do original,
TikTok,
Joe.
Stop.
Hold on.
TikTok,
that's the one we do.
Shout out DJ Camillo in here.
Come on.
Camillo, Camillo, Camillo.
Come on.
Bobby Brown, audition Bobby Brown, Bobby Brown, button on the sleeve.
That's what I do.
Sleeve, button on the sleeve, button on the sleeve.
Come on.
Lisa, Angela, Pamela, Renee, I love you.
Shampoo, straight face, you remember.
Hold on. I want a girl with extensions in her hair, bamboo earrings, at least two pairs.
Come on.
A Fendi bag and a bad attitude.
That's what I do.
That's all I need to get you in a good mood. She can walk with a switch and talk with street slang. I love it when a woman ain't scared to. Standing at the bus stop, sucking on a lollipop. Once she gets pumping, it's hard to make the hotties. She likes to dance to the rap jam. She's sweet as brown sugar with the candy yams. Honey coated complexion, music anime. Let's see it for the girls, she's from around the way.
You remember? You've never heard a Round the Way remix in your life.
Best move.
What's up,
it's me? Lisa Lisa's birthday.
I got it.
We gotta end this
on
Lisa Lisa. And I want to hear the slow jam too. I want to hear the slow jam too.
Joe.
So, nah. For real, we gotta represent first Boricua.
Joe, look,
first.
I haven't moved my hands, right? Hold on. Joe, is this what I do or this what I do? I don't play around, Joe.
You remember?
Hey, I'm trying to play around. Always ready. Always ready. Big tune. Big tune.
Alone on a Sunday morning.
Oh, Lord.
Outside I see the rain is falling.
Everybody side to side. Everybody side to side.
Inside I'm slowly dying, but the rain will hide my crying, crying, crying.
Just one hug, just one hug, just one hug.
Don't you know my tears will burn the pillow?
Oh, Lord.
You remember?
Set this place on fire, cause I'm tired of your lies. All I needed was a simple hello.
Everybody run it up!
But the traffic was so noisy that you could not hear my cry.
Camilla, what up?
My body never knew such pleasure. My heart never knew such pain. And you,
you
your leave me so confused.
Oh,
now I'm all cut.
Freestyle song ever, Information Society.
How did I know
as
that,
a kid,
as a kid, I snuck in the Devil's Nest. I might have been about 13, 14.
You remember?
First club I ever went to, and I was looking around at like disco lights and shit. And this record right here came on, and it changed my life.
Crazy.
The first club I ever walked in and seen the disco lights and everybody around, this shit came on. Play this shit right here, Ted.
Yo, let's get to that part, though. Let's get to that part. Oh, let's get to that part. Woo! Baseline.
I see.
Let me get the mic.
You gotta let it play.
Let me get the mic for you, Joe. Back and forth. Let me play. Baseline.
Information Society.
In this freestyle band, no, this is what I do. Nessie, what up? I finally see you.
Hot steamy night.
One more Judy Torres and I'm out of here. If you talk about the best freestyle, then you got to not play yourself and play a Judy Torres.
I'm getting to the bag.
I'm just saying, we got one more. I've been on here for 2 hours. We got Judy Torres.
You know what, man?
No, we got Judy Torres.
Joe, remember Judy Torres, Devil's Net, the blue dress? You remember the blue dress? Legendary. Let's get into it. Another one of the queens. Test move, fat jump, jump, and show. Me. You hear the vinyl popping? You hear the vinyl? You hear the scratching?
Shout out my man, Sal Abatello, Sal Abatello.
Hey, yo, Sal Abatello, what's the picture? Hold on. I tell my daughter all the time, I feel bad she never got to witness this era right here. Lord, man. It always took 3 minutes for the record to start, but it's all good. You remember? Wow. Cherry. Pepsi. I'm on it. Got the legendary Speedy in the building. Legendary Speedy. Because we couldn't take it there without playing this. Just one more. Can I hear Set It Off? Oh, my God,
Joe. I need Set It Off. I'm sorry, Ted.
No. You don't never got to apologize.
I just, we couldn't play all this freestyle without taking it to the bridge, to the Orchard Beach Section 5.
Joe, remember last time I played Set It Off on here and I threw the Mexican, you almost ran out the house.
On the left, on the right, on the left, I can get it.
I gave it a doofy.
On the left,
that's how we used to bring it down.
On the left, I can get it. While we're left,
set it off, I suggest y'all. Set it off, I suggest y'all. Set it off.
Y'all want this party?
Come on, let's put it on.
Right.
Set it off on the left, y'all. Set it off on the right.
Edgar Balanga on the check-in.
Stop playing games.
Yo, one of the greatest records of all time. It's the 4 Train. Bad Joe, I had Strafe 1 year come through at the old school jam. And better know was DJing. No! Camilla, do that freestyle set tonight, boy. Let's go.
Now, when this party started,
stop.
Right. Set it off. I suggest y'all set it off. I suggest y'all set it off.
Set it off.
Set it off on the left, y'all. Set it off on the right, y'all. Set it off. Come on, let's set it off.
Test move, straight face, you remember?
Y'all don't make me go there, Joe.
Test move, a ti hay que quererte, papi. A ti hay que quererte, papi. Yo, Ted, thank you for always lifting up the people, always coming on the show. We appreciate you too much. We appreciate you too much, Ted.
Love, bro.
Thank you for everything, my brother. I love you, and I'll speak to you soon, all right?
I already know. 100.
Peace. Happy birthday, Lisa, Lisa Cult Jam. A big inspiration to me. A person who opened the doors. We love you. It's Pepsi Wild Cherry. Vintage Frames, what's up? My girl, Bevelicious, Bevy Smith, got the new book out. Go get that. She's talking that shit. Put God first. I'll see you Monday. God willing, inshallah. Keep the faith. Keep focus. This will soon be over. Calm body, I see you, baby. Peace.